engaged to conduct the citizen research, and the focus of this particular study was citizen values. And I want to start by giving you a little bit of an overview of what we did and the methodology that we used. First of all, we surveyed Pinellas County citizens. The focus this time, instead of on budget, was focused more on citizen values. So what are their needs, what are their concerns, and how can those items be translated into strategic planning efforts? The methodology that we used was a outline methodology, where I included dialing. We completed 800 residential interviews between March, the end of March and early April. We conducted 200 interviews in each of the four regions of the county, north, south, mid, and the beaches areas. And we had an incidence rate of 20%, which basically means we made approximately 1,000 calls for the 200 completed in each region. We reduced the margin of error to plus or minus 4% from the previous 6%, so kind of the 95% confidence level. And we set specific demographic thresholds to ensure that we did have a representative sampling of residents and that there was no issue with the methodology influencing the demographics that we were reaching out to. A couple chart notes, some things that you'll see within the study. A lot of the tables reference an aggregate number, and that basically just means the total 800 interviews completed. Additional item to mention with that is we weighted the data based upon the population size of each of the four regions of study. Not all of the regions were of equal population size, so we wanted to make sure that we were getting true, fair representation of the true size of each of those regions. And again, we completed 200 per region, so when you see the breakdown of data by region, that's actually reflecting a full 200. And finally, there are some notes at the bottom of each of the slides, and there are some addendums to the copies that you have in front of you that have been made since those were printed, but there's nothing major, nothing content-wise or percentage-wise, just in terms of verbiage. All right, I want to start out by giving a summary. We had a representative sampling of Pinellas County residents, and we accomplished this through the random digit dialing methodology, which was our way. We were able to reach out to both cell phones and landline holders. And additionally, we varied the day of the week that we made the calls and the time of day to ensure we were getting a diverse subset of the population. We heard from a lot of long-term residents, which we were pleased with, because that they have a broader, longer-term point of reference, so they can provide in-depth information to us. Residents highly recommended Pinellas County as a place to retire, to live, to work, and to raise children. And we'll take a look at some of the specific demographic breakdowns when we get to that point. You'll see us reference ambassadors or promoters and detractors throughout the study, and that's just based on the aggregate. There were certain demographics that stood out as true ambassadors of Pinellas County in their recommendation ratings. Compared to the last 5 years, the quality of life in Pinellas County has been impacted, likely as a result of the recession and the economic recovery. The absolutely positive point is that there's optimism for the future. When asked for their perception of the future 5 years, quality of life is substantially better. There were certain community characteristics for which Pinellas County was identified as strongly aligning with the resident need. And we were also very pleased to see the reaction to Pinellas County residents in terms of the reasons that they provided for residing within Pinellas County. They were reflections of choice and not of circumstance. The next point, we looked at different county service areas and the perceived level of importance from the residents. And we noted that there were some demographic differences based on some demographic differences in the level of importance that each reported. And then the final point of summary is very few respondents plan to move away from Pinellas County within the next year. So that's definitely a very positive takeaway. This page shows the demographics of